I'm going to glow in white.
I'll explain what normally is in the master plan.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to America, the View from the Top. Today is a very hot summer day, and I don't mind telling you, you know, it is summer in 2015, and the years are flying. But we have very important issues that are coming up into our community, and I have the honor today to have Gary LaPelusa with us. He's one of our council members from the City Hall, and he's always been the one who's been up front and always come to help everybody. And I'm so pleased, Gary, that you were able to take time off from your job today to come in and address this very important issue about the redevelopment on 46th Street. That is affecting everybody and got everybody in an uproar right now in Bayonne. So welcome, Gary, and I'm going to give you the floor to talk about anything you, and I have a few questions. If you don't talk about it, maybe I'll get a chance to ask you. But please tell us what's going on, because everybody wants to know.
There is properties on the corner of West 46th Street, on the corner of Broadway. There's, I believe, five properties that go between Resnick's on the corner of 46th Street all the way to Dr. Morris Park. And then there'll be four properties going up West 46th Street, which a developer wants to build a large building. And normally, there is a process where the person who wants to, the developer who wants to build, will go before the planning board and then have his design either denied or approved. And if it's approved, then he'll start the process of building. If he wants to do something that's outside of the legal limits, he has to usually apply for a variance. And a variance would have to go usually before zoning and planning. That would have to be approved for them to do something out of the ordinary. We have a something called the master plan in Bayonne, which kind of guides us in what the town is looking for. These things sometimes change, so we have a new master plan just about every 10 years or so. Mm-hmm. It's been around 10 years since the last one. And what the master plan says is ideal for Broadway and Bayonne is usually first floor commercial and then up to four stories above it for residential apartments. And if you look on Broadway, there really isn't too many buildings over that four or five story limit.
I know.
And this developer is doing things differently. What's happening is they went to the planning board. The planning board sent something back to the council and then back to the planning board for a redevelopment area. And what they call it's an area in need of redevelopment. And some of the reasons that they called this area an area in need of redevelopment is because of blight. So they showed different pictures of the Resnick properties and different things of that it's kind of a little run down. And so that's why they're saying that this property would be ideal for new development. But in that redevelopment plan, it sets parameters. So like height requirements is probably the biggest issue right now. So the height requirement, if they wanted to do something outside the legal limit, a redevelopment plan would be denied or approved by the city council. would not need to go to zoning for a variance, because once it's voted on by the city council, it's like bypassing that step, and it's allowing a builder to build up to the height requirement that's listed in the redevelopment plan. This particular redevelopment plan for the Resnick properties allows the builder to build up to 120 feet, which is 12 stories. Now again, I just mentioned to you that there really isn't anything above five stories on Broadway.
Right.
So this would be more than twice the limit of what's of anything that's on Broadway. And currently, Resnick's is only maybe 2.5 stories tall also. So almost six times the size of what's there. And my personal opinion is that that's way too big. I don't think Broadway should be a canyon of large buildings. And what happens is this sets the tone for other large buildings. I am not against redevelopment, especially in that area. I would love to see a new building there. I just am against a 12-story building. I think that's way too high. And something else that people should know about is that I happen to live a block and a half up from this area, and I grew up around the block from this area, so I know this area very well. I've had probably 50 to 60 people contact me already about this project. Most of them are up in arms, really, really annoyed and against this project for the height. And just about everybody has said the same thing to me. They're in favor of new development. They don't want to see a building of that size. If you look at the neighborhood is made up of one and two family homes. And I don't remember how many are on each side. I really didn't count them, but I'm going to guess 40 to 50 homes on each side of the block.
Which affects 47th Street as well.
Absolutely. One of the things that's mentioned in the redevelopment plan is that a new building built for this redevelopment plan should keep the integrity of the neighborhood. And so that's one of the items that if the block is made up of one and two family homes, that this building would really not keep the integrity of the neighborhood. There's another issue also, and that is that a municipal code that we have, per each apartment, there's so many square foot for each apartment that has to be, there has to be open space for each apartment of so many square foot. So a one bedroom apartment, an efficiency apartment, you would need 150 square foot of open space around the building for each efficiency apartment. And then a one family, you would need 200 square feet, 250 for a two bedroom apartment. So if you look at the plan that the developer wants for this building at 88 units, which is what the developer wants to build, he would need roughly 17,500 square feet of open space. He wants to do some open space on the roof. So even if you include the area that he needs up on the roof, if that's included in part of the open space, he falls short about at least 8,000 square feet. So there's an issue there as well. Now normally, if you were going to build a tall building, you would have some sort of grass area, a lawn or a park or something that the developer will build, not something that's already there, because there is a park next door. But again, that's 7,500 square feet. The quality of life issues that are raised by building a building that tall are it blocks the sun. Mm-hmm. So it would block the sun of the park. It would block the sun of the people in the neighborhood who maybe they enjoy using the pool in their yard, and that would cut down on the amount of sun that they
and
would
the
have for their
too.
Pool. Their flowers, their vegetables, their trees, yeah. All of that would definitely cut down. And for people who bought there and enjoy where they're living, to now have to live in the shadow, and I mean shadow when I say that, of this building, obviously that's a quality of life issue, and that's something that as a councilman that I'm obviously against these issues that will hurt people's quality of life. And so these are the issues that the people in the neighborhood are very, very upset. They're upset with the amount of traffic that it's going to bring. Now, that's one issue that I can say it's a little difficult to actually say how much traffic is going to come to the neighborhood. There's also talks about a home being bought out on 47th Street where the cars might come in on 46th Street and exit on 47th Street, which would at least be a little better flow of instead of it coming in and out on the same block.
But what they forget is 47th Street is a street going east. And at any time of the day, you got a lot of traffic going there because it's only one block to Avenue E where the transit trains are over there too. Mm-hmm. So you've got to figure out how much traffic are you getting just on that street alone. Now that parking lot will be probably opening up in front of our door. Well, because we're near there. So
sure.
how would I be able to get out of my driveway at any time to try to get to where I'm going?
You know, there are growing pains with everything.
Yep.
And I'm not saying that that's what I want. Again,
nope,
I
understand.
I'm definitely against a 12-story building. But Greta, right now, you really don't have much residences there now. You have four, maybe two family homes there, and maybe some apartments above Resnick's and on Broadway. So let's say you have 20 families there that own cars, so you might have 20 or 30 cars there already. If you were to do a building maybe 6 stories or 7 stories, whatever, something of that nature, and you cut down on the amount of apartments, you'd still have an increase in traffic. But the area, I think, could handle that. It's within reason. There's never going to be a perfect scenario to make 100% of the people in the neighborhood happy. Somebody's always going to be upset with either an increased amount of traffic or, you know, again, maybe some of their views being obstructed because of a new large building. I believe in progress. I believe that I would really like to see a new building there. But looking at it, he might have the open space requirement if he cuts down on the amount of floors that he has. He may have an area where he can get the traffic flowing in and out because it won't all come at the same time either. So I think 47th Street might be okay if they cut down maybe that size of that building to a feasible number.
Mm-hmm.
Right now you have 2.5 stories on Broadway. So if it was another 2.5 stories or 3 stories, let's say, 4 stories, whatever it is, I think the area would still be able to keep the traffic because there's a double-decker parking garage that's going to be built with it. That's the plans that the developer has. And so that would allow enough parking for the apartments, also would allow some parking for people who are using the retail establishments, people who can park and you don't have to live there. If you're a shopper or you want to use one of the restaurants maybe that are there, you would be able to do that as well. So there are some good points to development. In this case, there are some parameters that I definitely do not like, and I know the neighbors don't.
And I even though we're on 47th Street, I might just go a block. You know, you have the bank, Bank of America. If I decide, because I have trouble walking, I take my car all the time, it's hard for me to find a parking space, even in that small 2 blocks.
Right. And Bayonne's always had issues with parking. That's never going to go away because of
terrible.
The
parking
town
is bad now. And I think if you did some kind of a survey, how many cars go by that area all the time on both streets?
Mm-hmm.
They should sit down and say, this is how many cars from midnight and then 1 hour each one, how many cars go down here and go there. Then you'd know how much traffic you have. And then you could say, well, we're going to have that much more traffic with the apartment. I don't know whether you'd like me to show. I have a picture here of that apartment building, if it's feasible to show it.
I don't know if that's the exact apartment building that the developer wants to build because he hasn't come up with a plan yet. So
but
I don't know.
This is the one that's on the computer that I got off. And maybe Adam could come in and just zoom in so we're talking about height and size of this.
Again, that's not the rendering that I had seen.
But this is the one that I saw today that I got on the computer.
From which site, though?
I forget what it's called, but it's, I got all the information from City Hall on this.
Okay.
At the same place where I got this here.
Okay.
But they've got six or seven different spaces that you can print out all the information that I was able to get. It's really, can you get a little tighter without, okay. Whoops. I hope that's not doing that inside.
No.
Okay. Well, you can see, this just gives you an idea of what we're talking about when we're talking about 12 stories. It certainly isn't feasible that this will fit in our neighborhood. And when you talk about the sun and the shadows and stuff, this is going to, not just on 46, 47, it's probably going to overflow on 45th and 48th.
I'm sure of it.
Mm-hmm. And maybe up your way, too.
Sure.
So, and the sun is very important because you need sunshine for your health. A lot of us are taking vitamin D3 because we're not getting enough sunshine.
Mm-hmm.
And that creates all kinds of problems
sure.
for your health.
Mm-hmm.
So health-wise, you know, you got to think about, we have a lot of older people on these blocks too. And I'm sure that health-wise, they may not all be in the best of health, but it's things to consider. And I can understand why they're upset about it because they've had a very tranquil life most of the time on those streets. And now at the end of their life, they're going to be bombarded with things they don't want to deal with. Not a nice way to go.
Yeah, I can understand what you're saying. And what you were saying about the traffic before, there are engineers whose it's their job to do traffic studies. And usually when a developer brings his plan to the planning board, that's one of the things that is spoken about, is the traffic study that was done and how many cars enter and exit at a certain time. And usually they'll want to especially do like rush hour in the morning or in the evening. When we know there'll be more cars on the road.
Right.
So that's something that we would like to see. But again, this is being done differently. And that's important for everybody to know that this was not done the traditional way. So it will be up to the City Council on the 22nd of July to either vote on this yes or no, or they could table it or put it off, or actually could change the parameters that are in the redevelopment plan. There's a number of different things that the City Council can do. And so, that's something that we'll have to see what happens on the 22nd.
Well, we just want to tell the people, too, that July 22nd at 7 o'clock at City Hall, there's going to be a meeting about this very subject we're talking about
this
right now.
This is one of the things on the meeting. It's a whole city council meeting that we have once a month.
And I would really advise all of you who are able to see this show on Sunday night at 8 o'clock, Tuesdays and Thursdays at 6 o'clock on Channel 19, Optimum Cable. I know some of you don't have it, but if you have it, you could share the show with other people. This is one way to get the word out. I'm trying to get as many people to see this so we can get as many people as we can down at City Hall, because your numbers are going to be very important. And, you know, if you want to write letters to your council people, your mayor, or City Hall in general, I wish that they really had a place where there was a letter put up already, whether you approve or disapprove, and they can kind of print it in, and that way, you know, you can alert your different council people that from that district they're not approving or whatever they want to say, because a lot of places have this already built in. You know, the City Hall should have that, but I don't think they do.
Well, as a council person, I wouldn't always want to do something in it, like to tell people how I felt about an item way in advance, because sometimes you don't have all the information, or you could learn something last minute that might make you decide a certain way on something. So for me personally, I've given you my feelings and I feel very strongly about them, but for another council person that maybe is unsure, maybe that's the reason why they wouldn't want to give you a determination in advance. They want to weigh everything out, and maybe they're going to wait and see. I personally am against this because I think the height is too high. But I'm also against this because I represent the people of that area uptown. And for me, I think there's more people who don't like this than like it.
Right.
And I have to represent those people. That's what the people voted for me to
that's
do.
That's right.
And so that's the reason why I've come on your show and I'm vocal about it. Ordinarily, if I was unsure about this, you know, it would be something that maybe I wouldn't want to voice my opinion because I have to vote on it.
Right.
It's different if you're a regular citizen, but for me, my vote counts 20%. We have five council people, so mine counts for one of the five. So if I was unsure, I wouldn't want to make that decision or at least speak about it in advance like that. So that's the only reason I'm saying why they can't do that in advance.
You know how I feel about these council people, and I mentioned it when I gave them the card inviting them to come here. I said, you know, maybe it's in a small area. We're talking about 46th, 47th Street or 45th or 48th Street. But, you know, when you people need help in this city, and you're not in our areas, but we help you. We'll come to your help. This is a time when we all should bind together and try to work for all the people in the community, not just a little section. Because that's the way a community is. They work together to make things happen for the benefit of the people who live there.
Now, Greta, I wanted to just tell you something else. The same developer wants to do a building very similar to this on Fifth Street, where Parapo Bank used to be, right on the corner. And pretty much similar, he wants to also develop that property with several properties to the right of it on Broadway. And if he hasn't purchased them already, I guess he has plans to. He's going to purchase several properties going up Fifth Street between Broadway and Avenue C. But the difference is the makeup of the blocks.
Yeah, it's a bigger street there.
Well, it's a two-way street, so it's much larger. Yeah. There's a very large tract of land across the street, which is mostly lawn. There's only two houses across the street from where this building is proposed to be built.
Isn't that a church or something?
And there is seven houses on the same side of the street where this development would be built. But some of those houses will be purchased and knocked down for this development, so you'll have less than seven even. Whereas 46th Street and Broadway, where this Resnick's property is, you gotta have 40 or 50 houses on each side of the street on every street that we mentioned. On 46th Street, there's probably 80 to 100 houses, and then 47th Street probably has 80 to 100 houses, and then, you know, each block basically has a large amount of one and two family homes. So again, if there was another area that this was built in and you wanted to do a 12-story or higher building and you had a lot of land around it, I wouldn't have a problem with it. So it's not
fine.
A matter of being against, like, per se, a 12-story building just in that area. That's where I'm against it. And I'll give you a perfect example. We have a lot of these empty gas stations on Avenue E. That would be the ideal space. You have railroad tracks behind you.
Right.
There's no residential apartments or houses there. You have a lot of open land around it. That would be the area maybe to build a large, tall building. It's close to the light rail. It's close to the turnpike. Ideal. And if you want to go high, I think the neighborhood could definitely sustain
The
traffic
buildings
would be good as well.
You get the apartments across the street from that part of it too. So
anyway.
It wouldn't be out of line. It seems it would kind of blend in.
But still, there's a lot of open space around it.
Yeah.
And all those open space requirements that we spoke about would probably be able to be met a little easier because there's already land there.
Right.
Some of it would probably have to be remediated, but they were able to do that on 45th Street when they built. And I know several other places. I'm pretty sure the same developer who's building on the boulevard in 43rd Street, he had to remediate that property before he built too, because anywhere there was a gas station usually has some sort of remediation involved.
Right.
And there was a gas station there as well as the one on 45th Street.
Yeah, that's been vacant years and years and years.
Mm-hmm.
They were waiting for the right time.
Absolutely.
But I think everybody is very, very nervous about this. They're thinking the worst, the worst of any scenario that you can think about, having this gigantic shadow, you know, in your face.
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly.
Yeah.
And the few trees that we have would be gone. It would be like being in New York City on a block.
Wow.
You would lose the integrity and the tapestry of the city Bayonne and the people who live in that area. That would just be gone.
Well, the people have come to me and they've asked me to basically be the liaison between the city council and them, and to speak to the mayor. And I've already done that a few times, and we're still talking, and I'm hoping that maybe we can reach out to the developer as well and maybe come to some compromise, or at least get the height down to a lower level where everybody can be happy. I don't know if that's possible. The best I can do is try my best to make a happy medium. Sometimes, like I said, there may be some people that'll be happy with that and some people that won't. But that's my job as councilman and as your neighbor. Yeah. And again, I know these people because I grew up with most of them. I know them probably 35 to 40 years.
Yeah.
So they're friends, neighbors, besides being constituents as well.
It's very personal. You know what's going mm-hmm. on. But the thing, usually before they do things like that, they have to do studies, and they usually have to send letters out to the public so that the public is aware of what's going on and try to get the people to give their opinions. It's a lot easier if everybody's agreeing on something than having a whole hundreds of people against you because of what you're doing.
Well, again, because this is being done differently than the normal way it's done, normally a developer would come to the planning board with a plan, and the planning board would look at the design of the building, look at the height also, the open space requirement, the parking, the traffic, and basically look at the economic impact on the neighborhood. They would look at a lot of different things besides what I've just mentioned. And then they can make a decision on whether they felt it fit in that neighborhood or whether it was right for the town. So when the planning board does that, they're basically giving the okay for the building to be built the way with the design that the developer has presented. There has been no plan presented to the city council, the planning board, or anybody. So I'm hoping that we can change some things in the redevelopment plan that might fit what the developer will still want to build and what the residents will be happy with, and everybody involved will be happy with. Again, we're going to try, and we don't know where this is going, but I have good feelings about what we're trying to do. And if we were to do that, I think there is a way to make everybody happy. I'm hoping. Now, the other aspect of this whole thing is that because of the way that they're doing it now by coming to the city council, if the city council was to approve this plan in the height of 120 feet, generally a builder is going to build usually to his maximum allowable, which would be the 12 stories. Even if he was to do 10 stories with his mechanical instruments on the top, it's still 12 stories. It's still 12 in height. So in that regard, if the city council was to change that and maybe say 6 stories or 8 stories or whatever it is that maybe they could come to, maybe the developer could be happy with that number. And maybe the residents could be happy.
Well, nobody knows how it feels unless it's in your backyard. Mm-hmm. And that becomes very personal. And I think there's a lot of things to be considered. I only had about 12 different things that I thought I would have to mention, but I was told that we have no more time.
Okay.
And we're going to have to wrap this up today. But at least please watch it, because I'm going to put this on the air right away, so we'll see it next week. And we'll keep running it until we feel confident that, you know, we're getting what we want as far as the information goes about this. So thank you, Gary, one more time for coming and enlightening all of us, just giving us the information that's really important. Thank you again, and let's pray that it's going to work out for the best of the community. Amen. So have a wonderful day. Thank you again for coming.
Thank you, Greta, for having me.
Having you here. Goodbye, everybody, and don't forget to watch the shows.